Canada's state building.
Let's go ahead and pan the camera to my guys real quick. There it is, New Hope Club. It's Z100. Yo, welcome back to New York, because you guys, you've been to the area plenty of times before. But now it's time for us to love again. I want to talk all things the tour that you just wrapped up, and you're getting ready for the headlining tour in the UK and the album. So I guess, where do we start? How does it feel to see the fans connect? I mean, globally now, you guys have you're veterans of the game.
Yeah, it's pretty wild. We've for the last 3 years, we've been doing support slots, which has been amazing. We've got to travel the world and see so many amazing places. But obviously, doing your own show is pretty. It's a very different thing to turn up to a venue and know that your crowd, people coming to see you, and everyone's working for you, and they're singing your songs, and it's crazy.
You get to play over an hour.
Yeah.
You have the choice to do whatever you want, and it's
We can drag it out for as long as we want. We can bore people if we want to.
Spend sometimes 5 minutes just telling our best joke. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Just
it doesn't even matter. Yeah. It's all choice with our songs.
This
it's just a matter.
It's fun.
Where in the world have you all stepped foot onto a stage and maybe become the most just blown away by the connection that you've had with the crowd? Has there been that city just yet? Because here in the States, you've been around here in the States, but I mean, as you get to go to these other places that require stamps on your passport, where were you the most surprised?
We've had a few shows where we've been
Amsterdam. I think it was just the standing was 1,800 or something.
Holy crap.
So that's the whole floor was huge, and it was we came out and it was obviously a sea of people. And we played our first two songs, and then before we played the third song, we went back to back the first two, and then we stopped. And they didn't stop screaming. I know it's they usually scream after a song, and we were thanking someone. It didn't stop, and we were just what
Holy
is going
crap.
On
is
right
this
now?
Real this life?
We broke the record for the venue of the loudest crowd.
Round of applause for that right there, because that's epic right there, dude. All right, so when you are stepping onto the stage and you luckily have the in-ears so you can hear yourself sing, making these songs come to life, what do fans or new fans of yours, what should they expect when they come to a New Hope Club show?
Energy, a lot of energy. We love it when people sing along.
We get a bit sweaty.
We're gonna get very sweaty.
A little bashy.
Yeah. just have a fun time. It's obviously, when you want to go to a gig, you just want to feel safe and just sing along. So that's what we want our fans to have as well.
So for those that don't quite know, to be connected with another group, phenomenal, the guys from the Vamps. We got to talk about the origin story and how this brotherhood.
You've had it here first.
Why did you say?
Did you not hear about the fallout? Did you not hear?
To be amongst brothers here, the three of you, man. What's it like to be able to share the stage and share the energy? Lending a hand, from another just successful group. What's it like?
Yeah, no, the Vamps boys have helped us so much. I mean, they're just our friends, realistically. From the start now, they've helped us on stage, backstage, just being humble guys.
Yeah, yeah.
And they're just, if you've ever met them, you know that they're
the
just
nicest
lovely
dudes.
Guys. And I think we've learned a lot from them musically and as people. Just very, very nice people. We still link up.
Every once in a while.
Still very good friends. We write a lot with... Brad, pretty much.
Oh, sweet.
We write songs with him, so...
That's one of the things I wanted to talk about was the songwriting process. I mean, the fact that you guys are so heavily involved in that. And, in the songs, how fun is it to watch your words come to life and to see them all the way through from start to finish?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, when you're on stage and you're playing a song you've written, it's like an incredible feeling. But obviously...
Yeah.
When we're not on tour, I mean, we try and write on tour, but it is really hard. Mm-hmm. So when we get time to sit in the studio and actually just start being creative and just, because on tour you start it's your own routine,
For
you're
sure.
On the tour,
you got a sound check you got to meet.
Yeah,
you have a curfew. You got to do all those things that keep you fresh to perform your best in the next stop. Yeah.
And then we get to when we go into the studio, we can just stop, just look about what our favorite parts of our music and where we want to go and listen to the music we want to go into. And we can just... It's such a creative, fun time because we have no limits. We can just do what we want now. And obviously, can literally, we don't have to go to like the best studio in the world. Like, yeah, we can literally just set it up in my room and just do it from there. It's just so easy.
That's some of the most amazing stuff that I've ever heard. The fact that you're able to create, just when the moment hits you, when the yeah, session feels right, you can make your own session. Where's the most random place that you have created a studio?
A studio.
Or like you put together a session, well, you made a song, yeah.
We wrote a song on a plane.
Oh.
And then Blake started producing it on a train back to his house.
Are you
so
kidding
it was
me?
Written on transportation. Yeah.
Like it was a full start to finish transportation.
Yeah. Yeah, it was
and
our song
what
called,
the crap?
Yeah, it's called Karma and it's out. And it's like, we wrote it on a plane back from Germany.
Are you kidding me?
And then that's Blake started creative. The production and we finished it off the next day. It was so,
that's
it was mad.
That's gnarly as hell.
Like no guitar was involved in the writing of the song either.
No,
it was just all like
all dum, 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 dum.
Oh, holy cow, dude. I do got to talk about, you know, the brand new single. I'm looking at the picture now. Hold on. It's a Polaroid.
Sexy, isn't it?
It's, yeah, the dashing gentleman. Just stand. I'm trying to do my best.
You know.
You could just Photoshop me into this right here.
Yeah.
Love Again. I mean, just tell me about this particular song. And what does this one mean to you all?
Love Again is our new single. We named our tour after it.
Yeah.
The Love Again World Tour. And it's a song I'm very proud of. It's a song all about that feeling when you've had a love. And that love has ended,
yeah.
And then you see them again, and it brings back all the feelings that you had. And I think a lot of people have been through that. I know some of us
George,
have been through
George,
that.
Yeah.
No names, no names.
Tearing up.
Yes,
George,
George over
come
here tearing
on,
up.
Come
yeah,
on,
man.
Keep it together,
get
man.
The camera off me, man.
Turn the cameras on me, please.
And yeah, the fans love the song, and it's really cool to play live, and we're proud of it.
Yeah, let's talk about this name of the tour after, and you know, getting ready to take over this headlining tour in the UK, in Europe. Gosh, man, getting out there on stage night in and night out, it doesn't get old, right?
Never.
No.
Never.
Every crowd's different as well. Like,
yeah.
Like, it's true. Like, every crowd is slightly different, and you played every show is different as well. Like, things happen, the shows and stuff like that.
We played our first headline shows in Korea this time.
That's insane.
That was madness.
Yeah.
We put a show on, and then the same day, we put another show on, so we did two shows in one day. We had like a matinee show.
Holy crap!
And then a show at night. Yeah.
It was in a musical.
And then the day we was like literally exhausted. But it's so much fun.
Great fun.
I mean, again, it's because anyone who has seen a show, I've been only, I mean, crap, because I'm stuck here in a studio all the time. I think we talked about this outside the room. I've had to live vicariously through, you know, social media and YouTube and watching it all come to life. But anyone who knows is it's exactly what you said. It's energy. It's from start to finish. It's screaming. It's connectivity. You guys are looking in the eyes of so many fans that are just dialed in. I mean, even though it's in Korea and they don't even speak English as maybe their first, second, or third language.
They know the words.
Mad, yeah.
They sing the words. It's crazy.
Gosh, I just want somebody to sing the words to something that I've created in a different language. I'm just saying. But I'm not good at creating at all. Here's where I want to throw some rapid fire questions your way so we can get to know you guys before you hit our Z100 Summer Bash party that we're going to be throwing down tomorrow. You excited about this? All right. So,
bash it out.
Yeah, we're going to bash it out, you guys. Here you go. First question. Last person that you texted?
My mom.
Oh,
she's at a
honestly,
gig right now.
Oh. Ben, to find out what time we need the lobby to be here.
Okay, so. What's one thing that you miss from home when you're on the road?
My little dog, Betty.
Oh, no, you're Betty. Just trying to melt all the hearts, aren't you?
No, I do. And my family.
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
And we've got her here today.
Yay!
Yay!
Oh, yes, come in my suitcase. Oh, wait.
Who would you be surprised or really excited to find out as a New Hope Club fan? Like, what celebrity
Paul
on the
Kearney
planet?
Would be the best one.
Wow. Actually, I've heard
madness.
That. He tweeted
or
it the
other
day.
Or someone like Will Ferrell.
Yeah.
Well, that'd be
you know
sick.
What I mean?
Sir Paul McCartney and Will Ferrell. That is like the most.
Just imagine if Will Ferrell just like loved our tunes.
Just
stuff like that is just so random.
Yeah. That is so
crazy.
He's
laughing. I'm getting kidding.
He's so happy.
Imagine.
He's smiling.
What is your least favorite American slang word?
Ooh.
Dude. Rap,
no, I don't mind dude. This is the first one that came to
dog,
mind.
Like,
I'm
dog.
Not,
like dog.
What's
like,
up, dog?
Dog.
What's up, dog?
I'm not a massive fan of...
Is that a
Ben quite likes using this word, but I don't like rad. That's rad.
Rad.
Go on now, Ben in the corner
over
there.
I don't think he uses it serious.
No.
And here's the last one. As we talk about different vernacular, why is it really weird that you guys you use the word fanny different than us?
Fanny?
Yeah.
Why? What do you use it for?
Well, I mean, we call the back end your fanny.
Yeah.
Yeah. But
we have such thing as a fanny pack.
But isn't it called a bum bag?
That goes on the front.
Fanny
pack
goes on the front.
The fanny pack goes on the fanny on the back.
No.
Oh, dude, I think we just started another world war here.
No, this is what I'm really confused about. I never knew you called it a fanny.
Yeah, we call the back a
fanny.
Isn't
that a hiney?
I'm breaking it down. We do Hope Club here today. Our hiney is what we call fanny.
Botox.
Buttocks.
The buttocks.
Yeah, fanny for you guys is what it's a little different.
The fanny pack.
Yes, that's a whole different from bottom. Genre.
We don't delve.
I just think I blew these guys' minds, man. Oh, man. Hey, before we wrap things up in here with New Hope Club, performing at
we
our sold out.
We don't have fanny.
I've got a fanny.
Well, both types, right? Yeah, I mean. I like the fanny.
Don't shoot me. 2019.
We've lost control. Oh, my gosh. Z100 Summer Bash, man. What's it mean for you guys to be a part of this amazing party? Thank you guys for being here with us, but
thanks
also to team up with us here at Z100. I mean, how cool is that going to be?
Honestly, such a pleasure for us to do it. It's going to be fun, and I'm excited to see what tomorrow's going to be like.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, hopefully they're going to be – I don't know what time is it.
I think we're 4:30, 5, right in the middle of the afternoon,
well,
dude.
It should be prime time for them releasing some energy.
Bit rowdy.
Kick off.
Popping off, rowdy.
I'm being honest.
Kick off.
Try our best.
Dude, you guys do it. You don't have to try your best. We all are fans for a reason, and I just got to say thanks for bringing the energy. Thank you for creating from the heart, and thanks for just being who you are, because I mean that's naturally why we all gravitate towards the music. So
thank you so much.
Good luck early on this second half part of the tour, being back home and hitting different places where you're getting new passport stamps. Kill it,
and we just got new passports.
We
quite
did.
Emotional because we filled the other ones and I'm gonna definitely frame it.
I've got we've all got 3 passports now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're all bowling in passports.
Like 9 passports.
We're making it rain.
what travel. Would you want, mate?
We're like 2 chains, but 3 passports.
3 passports!
3 passports!
Yeah!
It's New Hope Club here hanging out on Z100. Round of applause, you guys.
Thank you.
Cheers, man.
From the top of the Empire State Building. Z100.